Is it possible for a legacy to be both tarnished and triumphant? This is a question that often arises when discussing the life and career of Lance Armstrong, the once celebrated, then vilified, and now somewhat redeemed figure in the world of professional cycling. Born in the small city of Plano, Texas in 1971, Armstrong displayed an aptitude for sports from an early age. His mother, Linda, was a teenager when she gave birth to him, and it was her indomitable spirit and work ethic that undoubtedly shaped Armstrong's resilience and determination. In his teenage years, Armstrong found his calling in the arduous sport of triathlon, where he began to make waves, eventually transitioning to professional cycling, the tender age of 16. His early promise was soon realized when he became the world champion in 1993, just 2 years after turning professional. However, Armstrong's life took a devastating turn in 1996. At the peak of his career, he was diagnosed with testicular cancer, a disease that had metastasized to his lungs and brain. Faced with a prognosis that gave him less than a 40% chance of survival. However, Armstrong chose to fight. His battle with cancer was arduous. He underwent surgery and extensive chemotherapy. His determination and resilience paid off, and by 1997, he was declared cancer-free. This experience profoundly changed him, leading to the creation of the Lance Armstrong Foundation, now known as Livestrong Foundation, to support cancer patients and survivors. His spirit unbroken. Armstrong's return to professional cycling was nothing short of spectacular, winning the Tour de France, the most prestigious event in the sport, not once, not twice, but an unprecedented 7 consecutive times from 1999 to 2005. Armstrong was not just a champion, but a symbol of hope and resilience, an inspiration to millions around the world. But the fairy tale story soon turned into a nightmare. Despite his success, rumors and accusations of doping dogged Armstrong throughout his career. He consistently denied any wrongdoing and aggressively fought back against accusers. However, the truth began to unravel in 2012, when the United States Anti-Doping Agency, USADA, presented evidence that Armstrong had been part of a sophisticated doping program. Armstrong was stripped of his Tour de France titles and banned from professional cycling for life. In 2013, Armstrong publicly admitted to using performance-enhancing drugs during his Tour de France victories in an interview with Oprah Winfrey. This admission shocked the world and tarnished his legacy. Sponsors dropped him, and he faced numerous lawsuits and financial penalties. 2012, Armstrong was stripped of his titles and banned from professional cycling for life after a doping scandal that shook the sporting world. The man who had been a beacon of hope was now seen as a symbol of deceit. The fall from grace was harsh. Armstrong became a pariah, his achievements overshadowed by the scandal. Yet, true to his nature, Armstrong refused to be defeated. He admitted to his mistakes, accepted the consequences, and began the long journey to redemption. In the years following his fall from grace, Armstrong has sought to rebuild his life and reputation. He has focused on his foundation's work, advocating for cancer research and support. While his legacy as a cyclist remains controversial, his contributions to cancer awareness and survivorship continue to have a positive impact. Lance Armstrong focuses his energy on raising awareness about cancer and supporting those affected by the disease through his foundation, Livestrong. His life, marked by soaring highs and crushing lows, serves as a stark reminder of the human potential for both greatness and fallibility. In conclusion, The legacy of Lance Armstrong is a complex one. It is a tale of victory, defeat, scandal, and redemption. It is about the human spirit's ability to triumph over adversity, but also its capacity for deceit. Armstrong's story teaches us that our heroes are human, capable of great achievements, but also susceptible to temptation and error. As we reflect on his life, we are left with a profound question. Can a legacy be both tarnished and triumphant? Perhaps the answer lies not in the deeds of the past, but in the actions of the present and the promise of the future.